بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب زدني علما.
The next thing we'll try to understand, the next thing we'll try to see the different types of questions what you generally face in the certification exams. Like CCNA, if you take any CCNA exam or any CCNP exams or any Cisco exams except the CCI lab, because CCI lab is completely a practical exam which you need to appear, 8 hours lab exam, which is totally different. But apart from CCI lab, if you go with any, most of the exams, they all have a common pattern. Or the types of questions will be common. Like you have a single choice, multiple choice questions. Basically, it can be either single choice or multiple choice, any one of this, or testlet, drag and drop simulations, or simulators. So let's see, if you want to just have an idea how these questions will be, you have a demo video here. So probably I can click on this URL. Basically, this URL will allow you to download, but I cannot do that. Mostly some of the browsers, they don't support. So if you just go to go and search for CCNA exam demo file, basically on the Cisco website, you have a different demo files. This is the file you have to download. So if I click on this, it will download. So I can download this. Already it is downloaded, so I don't need to do this. I can open this one, okay? So when you click on this, probably this works with Explorer, Internet Explorer, so it doesn't work with my Flash, sorry, Google Chrome here. Now again, once you download this file, this is like a demo file, which will give an overview of how the examination will be, the computer-based exam. So we have a single choice, multiple choice, single answer questions, where you'll be given multiple choices, but you have to tick any one of the correct answer. This is the first question, and you can click on next, continue here, to just see the next type of question, what you'll see. Now again, the multiple choice, multiple answers, where you have to select the multiple answers. Like here, we have three correct answers, so we have to tick three correct answers. So in the exam, in the question, they will mention how many correct answers, so you don't need to worry whether two are correct or three correct, so it will be clearly mentioned in your question. Now the next type of questions, we have something like drag and drop. In the drag and drop, what we'll be doing is you'll be given some options. Now we have to drag these options and place in the appropriate column. So you can use your mouse, just drag and drop, you know how we do with the mouse, probably those options, arrange them in the order. You can also try this by clicking on try me. You can just click on try me and you can drag and drop like this, okay. I'm just randomly dropping, not the correct answers, but just an example. So the next type of questions, fill in the blanks, you don't find in today's networks maybe, but you may have this kind of questions where you may need to just type in the correct answer. This is a little bit rare, but you may see this kind of questions. And the next thing, simulation. Simulation are the most important ones and also the most weighted questions, because they will carry more points, because this is a little bit based on the labs, what you do, the practical. So in this, you'll be given a scenario. Probably you need to read and understand the scenario and of course the task, what you are supposed to do. And once you do the task, then you will be given a diagram and you have to go to the command line and you have to exactly execute the commands or type the commands here, as you can see here. So let me try it out, try me. And you can see this is your scenario and then this is your task and from other information, and you can see this is the console cable. So if you want, you need to go and configure this router. We need to go to the command line. You can do that by clicking on this PC, which is having a console cable here. So this is how it is represented. And once you go to the command line, now here I can type in the exact commands, probably to go into the enable mode, whatever the configurations you do it. So it's not actually a real device, it's just a simulation program. So basically, whatever the commands you execute here, as per the task, depending upon the correctness of the commands, basically you will be given the points. So they, you may have 3 to 4 simulations expected in the examination. So again, that is one option, one type of questions. And apart from that, you have other type of questions, like you have testlet questions. Now in this testlet, you will be given some kind of scenario or diagram or few things probably. So you need to read this complete scenario and try to understand the scenario or the diagram, whatever is given to you. And based on this, you will have a set of 3 to 4 questions. Like you can see, this is the first question, second question, third question, fourth question. And you have to move to that particular questions and you have to tick the correct answers. You can see the file is going to show you. Probably you can also try it. You can click on second question, third, and the fourth questions like this. So you'll find the answers in this passage. Probably if you read this scenario or try to understand this one, you will get a clear information on this. So based on that, just like you have a paragraph writing, you know, a paragraph question based on the paragraphs, probably in English grammar, similar to that. Now the final option, we have simulate. Simulates are same like a lab option, where you'll be given a diagram and you can go to the command line of this device. And the question says, what is the IP address? So in order to know the IP address, you have to execute a command called show IP interface brief or show run to find the correct answer. So you can see here in this simulation, he has used show run command to see what is the IP. And you can see there is an IP here. I think this one or whatever the IP you can see. And you have to tick the correct answer from that. So here you are not going to make any changes. Basically, you're going to figure out what will be the answer, and you can only verify that once you go to the command line and once you execute some basic show commands to find the correct answer. Okay, so these are the different types of questions what you will see, and the weightage of these questions will be different. Like most of the simulation labs will have a more points or more weightage compared to other questions. And roughly you can have 3 to 4 simulations, maybe 2 to 3 simulates, maybe 2 to 3, you know, drag and drop questions. And testlet also, maybe you can have 3 to 4 or 4 to 5 random. I'm not saying exact, but it is like, and rest of the questions will be a single choice or multiple choice. So which means if you just count these type of questions, like 4 into 4, probably around 15 to 20 questions on these different scenarios. And rest of the questions will be either a single choice or multiple choice questions.